Google just declared war on hackers, and they think they've won. Android 14 landed with a stack of hardening and faster patch delivery that makes it one of the toughest mobile platforms to attack. We're talking hardware-backed boot integrity, deeper kernel protections, and more proactive malware defenses. So today, I'm going to answer the question that's keeping both hackers and security professionals awake at night. Is Android 14 Plus actually the impenetrable fortress Google hopes it is? Or are we just dealing with a shinier lock that's waiting to be picked? Welcome back to Tech Sky. Buckle up, because we're about to dive into the most sophisticated mobile security battlefield ever created. Let me paint you a picture of what Google has built. Android 14 isn't just an operating system update. It's a continuation of a multi-year rebuild of mobile security from the ground up. First, there's Project Mainline. It sounds boring, but it's huge. Google can now push critical security components through Google Play system updates without waiting for carriers or manufacturers. Think of it as a rapid response patch lane that can close doors before attackers widely exploit them. The secure boot process is tied directly to a hardware root of trust. Every stage in the boot chain is cryptographically verified. If a partition is tampered with, the device warns or refuses to boot depending on policy. That makes persistent compromises much harder. App isolation is the foundation. Each app runs in its own Linux UID sandbox enforced by SE Linux. Permissions and background restrictions keep apps in their lane, and Android 14 continues tightening those lanes, like blocking installs that target very old API levels and offering more granular media access options, including letting users grant access to only selected photos and videos. Under the hood, Android layers classic exploit mitigations. ASLR and KASLR, control flow integrity, and on supported hardware, features like pointer authentication or memory tagging. Add in a hardened allocator and more platform code written in memory-safe languages, and many bug classes are simply harder to turn into reliable exploits. And malware defenses? Google Play Protect now performs real-time scanning and code analysis, with on-device signals helping catch malicious behavior early. It can warn, block, or disable harmful apps, even those from outside Play, giving average users a fighting chance. This evolution has made a lot of yesterday's attack playbooks look like museum pieces. Remember when you could root an Android phone with a single kernel bug and a vendor driver? Today, you often need multiple chained vulnerabilities, a way to leak addresses, a reliable primitive for memory corruption, and a sandbox escape, just to get stable code execution. Old app layer mistakes still matter, but the OS won't magically save you from them. If a developer writes unsafe SQL, SQL injection can still happen inside that app's data store. The difference is, the damage is more contained by app isolation and scoped storage. The classic route of abusing set user ID binaries has largely been retired. Android moved to Linux capabilities and tight SE Linux policies, which reduces, but doesn't eliminate, paths to privilege escalation. Even something as basic as sideloading a malicious APK is harder to pull off quietly. Package installs face stricter checks, and Play Protect's real-time analysis increases the odds malicious code gets flagged before or shortly after it runs. Android Debug Bridge, a longtime favorite for low-level access, now requires explicit user authorization and pairing keys. In consumer devices, it isn't silently enabled. In enterprise, admins can lock it down via policy. That removes many easy doors that used to be left ajar. Bottom line, if you're still using techniques from a couple of years ago, you're bringing a knife to a missile fight. The bar is higher, the windows are smaller, and the ladders are greased. But here's where the story gets really interesting. Hackers haven't given up. They've evolved. The new battleground isn't about obvious misconfigurations. It's about 0 days buried deep in the stack. Bootloaders, firmware interfaces, kernel subsystems, or the seams where multiple security systems interact. Modern Android exploits often require teams of specialists working for months. You need people who understand ARM internals, Linux kernel behavior, cryptographic implementations, and vendor-specific hardware quirks. Reliable chains are rare and expensive. Social engineering has leveled up too. Instead of clumsy phishing, attackers craft believable multi-week narratives, tailored pretexts that nudge targets to install helpful tools or enable risky settings, all while staying below the alarm thresholds. Supply chain compromises are a growing risk surface. Why break in at the OS if you can taint a component earlier? At the factory, in third-party libraries, or in the developer tooling that ships on devices? Some of the nastiest incidents start well before the box is opened. Malware has gone modular and adaptive. Rather than one monolithic app, attackers deploy a small constellation of innocuous-looking apps that communicate, assemble capabilities at runtime, and blend in until it's time to act. For ethical hackers and security researchers, Android 14 Plus is both a crisis and an opportunity. Drive-by scanners won't cut it. You need to understand how subsystems compose. The app sandbox, binder IPC, SE Linux domains, vendor drivers, secure boot, and how mitigations like CFI and KASLR affect exploitability. Bug bounty hunting is still viable, but the Pareto easy wins are gone. The vulnerabilities that remain tend to be subtle race conditions, logic bugs at trust boundaries, or memory safety issues that require clever info leak strategies to weaponize. Knowing the Android open source project isn't optional. You'll trace call paths across frameworks, HALs, and kernel, and read patches to spot new assumptions. Memory safe rewrites remove entire bug classes. The remaining ones demand depth. Fuzzing has matured from spray and pray to targeted input generation. Teams guide fuzzers toward tricky state transitions and edge case parsers, sometimes assisted by ML, to reach paths humans overlook. Timelines are longer. Where a bug once went from discovery to exploit in days, serious Android research can span months or more, especially if you're aiming for a full chain from app to kernel to persistence. Looking ahead, the arms race is only accelerating. Google is leaning into on-device intelligence for protection. Think PlayProtect's live threat detection and newer anti-theft and anomaly resistance features on supported devices, while keeping critical security components updatable via mainline. Hardware security is moving from encrypt and hope to detect and respond. Expect more use of dedicated security processors, better fault injection resistance, and hardware-assisted memory protections on the latest SoCs. Machine learning is a tool for both sides. Defenders use it to catch suspicious behaviors earlier. Attackers use it to discover vulnerable code patterns and to scale personalized social engineering. Cloud integration expands the battlefield. Your phone's safety now intersects with backups, account integrity, and server-side checks. Strong device security still depends on the health of the services it talks to. Post-quantum cryptography is coming online in the wider ecosystem. Pilots in browsers and TLS stacks are paving the way. Android is part of that migration path, but it won't flip overnight. Transitions always create new edges to probe. And with phones acting as keys for your car, your home, even medical devices, compromise isn't just about data anymore. It's about the physical world connected to that device. So is Android 14 Plus hackable? The answer is both yes and no. For ScriptKiddie tooling you downloaded last year? Mostly no. Android 14 Plus has ended the era of casual, one-click mobile hacks. For sophisticated, well-funded teams with deep stacks of talent? Yes. No platform is perfect, and complexity creates novel failure modes. For the average ethical hacker or security researcher? It depends on your depth, your patience, and your willingness to learn the system's internals. The democratization of mobile exploitation has narrowed. Professionalism is the new entry fee. What's fascinating is how defense and offense are co-evolving. As Android hardens, attackers innovate. The margin for error is tiny, the technical bar is high, and the game keeps moving. If you're serious about operating at this level, hit subscribe and join us as we explore the cutting edge of this digital battlefield. Because one thing is certain, the war between security and exploitation is just getting started. What do you think? Has Google finally built an unbreakable system, or are we just waiting for the next generation of hackers to prove otherwise? Drop your thoughts in the comments. Until next time, stay curious, stay ethical, and remember, in cybersecurity, the only constant is change. This is TechSky, signing off.